What is jugular venous pressure or jugular venous pulse? Is it pulse or is it a pressure? What do you think, doctor? Is it not a pulse? Gee, doctor. JVP stands for both jugular venous pressure and jugular venous pulse. But jugular venous pulse is actually not a real pulse. What are the characteristics of a pulse? Pulse is a rate, pulse is a rhythm. Pulse is a character and pulse is always palpable. But GVP is not palpable. Seen better than felt. While pulse felt better than seen. To jugular venous pulse is a misnomer, such as osteoarthritis. What do you mean arthritis? Osteoarthritis is the inflammation of the joint. But osteoarthritis is not an inflammatory disease. So it is a misnomer. Osteoarthritis is a degenerative disease of articular cartilage. All the inflammatory markers, including ESR, CRP, will be normal in case of osteoarthritis. Such as ganglion, cyst, a lump over the wrist, around the tendon is called ganglion cyst. But as we know, ganglion is the collection of neuron in the peripheral nervous system. So it is a not nerve. So it is a misnomer. In medical literature, we pass a lot of misnomer, such as jugular venous pulse is a misnomer. It is not actual a real pulse. It is a not palpable. It is better seen than felt. Jugular venous pressure is actually reflect the right atrium pressure. It is nearly accurate measurement of right atrium pressure, jugular venous pressure. How JVP waves form? A wave, C, V wave. There are three positive wave and two drop. X descent and Y descent. Is it clear? How the A wave is formed? A wave indicate atrium contraction. Right atrial contraction indicate A wave. This is the right atrium. This is right ventricle. If the right atrium start contracting, still tricuspid wall is closed. There is isometric contraction. Blood will move upward in the internal jugular veins. It will form the A wave. JVP is actually is a blood column. It is not a pulse. It is a blood column, and it is checked in the internal jugular veins on the right side because of its direct continuity with the right atrium, and the internal jugular vein is no walls. If the atrium start contracting, tricuspid wall still is closed, the blood moves upward in the internal jugular vein, it will reflect the A wave. Jugular venous pressure is nearly accurate measurement of right atrial pressure. And it is not a pulse, it is the actual movement of the blood column. Is it clear? Then, as the tricuspid walls open, as the tricuspid wall open, blood rush from right atrium into right ventricle, the atrium start relaxing. It will form the X-descent. X-descent means atrial relaxation. This is the C waves. C wave is formed is the right ventricle start contracting. This tricuspid wall bulge into right atrium. Tricuspid wall bulge into right atrium. Right atrium pressure again increases. It will form the C wave. Is it clear? C par bulging up tricuspid wall into right atrium with ventricular contraction. C is not visible on clinical examination. A and V are visible. What is the most prominent wave on the examination of JVP is the A wave. V waves indicate this is the tricuspid. This is the inferior vena cava. This is the superior vena cava. We indicate venous filling from inferior vena cava and superior vena cava into right atrium. Inferior vena cava and superior vena cava into right atrium. Tricuspid wall is closed. Hence the venous return is coming into right atrium through inferior vena cava and superior vena cava. Right atrial pressure will form the V wave. This is the V wave. V par venous filling from inferior vena cava and superior vena cava. Y descent. If the right atrium start contraction, tricuspid valves open, blood rush into right ventricle, the atrium become empty. Why doesn't mean right atrial emptying with repeat filling up right ventricle? These are the waves formed on the JVP. As you examine the JVP, how you come to know it is a A wave or V wave? Kaise pata chalega? Do you have any idea? As you observing the JVP, you always compare it with carotid pulsation. You put the thumb on the left carotid and you observe the wave. A wave comes before carotid pulsation. V waves comes just after the carotid pulsation. The waves that is visible before the carotid pulsation, that is the A wave. It is coincide with fast start sound. And the V wave just after the carotid pulsation, and it is coincide with second heart sound. What are the abnormalities? Waves abnormalities. What are abnormalities on JVP? Absent A wave. As we know, A par atrium contraction, right atrium contraction. If there is no contraction, the A wave will be absent. The example is atrial fibrillation. Atrial fibrillation. There is no contraction, A wave will be absent. Joint A wave. What are the causes of joint A wave? Joint mean large, larger than normal. Joint A wave, if there is any blockage in the outflow tract, if there is tricuspid stenosis, right atrium needs more pressure to overcome this stenosis. It will form joint A wave. Tricuspid stenosis, pulmonary stenosis, pulmonary hypertension. These are the common example of joint A wave. And what are the causes of canine A wave? What do you mean canine? Canine ka lafzi matlab kya hai? Thop. Canine thop, explosive. Canine A wave occur in complete heart block, ventricular tachycardia. Complete heart block form canine A wave. Right atrium is contracting forcefully against the closed tricuspid wall. Right atrium and right ventricle, they are contracting independently. So canine A wave is seen intermittently as an explosive. Canaan A wave is larger A wave than a giant A wave. Giant V wave. What are causes of giant V wave? Larger V wave. Tricuspid regurgitation. As we know, the V wave is formed by the venous filling, right atrial venous filling. Venous return coming from inferior vena cava and superior vena cava into right atrium, right atrial bulk of a pressure. If there is a tricuspid regurgitation, if the ventricular start contracting, blood will regurg through this diseased valve into the right atrium. The pressure will increase more and more. It will form the tricuspid. It will form V wave, giant V wave. It indicates the tricuspid regurgitation. And what are the causes of small X descent? Small X descent. Tricuspid regurgitation and prominent X descent cardiac tamponade. Is the venous return impaired in case of cardiac tamponade? What are the causes of slow Y descent? Tricuspid stenosis and causes of a sharp Y descent is constrictive pericarditis, cardiac tamponade. These are the abnormalities of JVP wave path. How to measure JVP? Suppose patient is lying at 45 degree angle. This is the esternocleidomastoid muscle. This is the neck of the patient. This is the external angle. Patient is lying at 45 degrees. Remember that this suppose is the right atrium. External angle just lie around 5 centimeters above the right atrium. Your right atrium up to the external angle. External angle is the reference point for the measurement of JVP. From right atrium up to the external angle, it is nearly 5 centimeters. External angle lies around 5 centimeters above the right atrium. This is the reference point. And you observe the as we know the jugular venous pulse, JVP, this is observed in internal jugular vein. This internal jugular vein run along the sternocleidomastoid muscle. We observe the upper limit. Suppose this is the upper limit. This is the upper limit of venous pulsation. We put a scale or ruler horizontally at the upper limit of venous pulsation and another ruler at the external angle in vertical position. Then we measure distance between them vertically. Then we measure this vertical distance. If this vertical distance greater than 3 centimeters, we say JVP is elevated. Where is the upper limit of venous pulsation? You put one scale like this in horizontally and other scale or ruler at the external angle vertically. Then you will measure the vertical distance between them. If this vertical distance greater than 3 centimeters, we say JVP is elevated. Why? As we know, the mean right atrial pressure is 8 centimeters of water, 8 centimeters of blood column. From external angle to right atrium is 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters plus 3 centimeters is equal to 8 centimeters. Suppose the vertical distance is 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters plus vertical distance is 5 centimeter is equal to 10 centimeter. 10 centimeter. As we know, the right atrial mean pressure is 8 centimeter and our calculation is 10 centimeter. The JVP is elevated. JVP is raised. If it is greater than 3 centimeter, JVP is raised. Abdomino jugular reflux or hepato jugular reflux. What is clinical importance of abdomino jugular reflux? पहले जमाने के लोग इन ओल्ड मेडिकल लिटरेचर इट इज़ नेम्ड एज एपटोजोगुलर रिफ्लक्स, लेकिन रिसेंट मेडिकल लिटरेचर में इन्हें एब्डोमिनो जोगुलर रिफ्लक्स कहते हैं. व्हाट इज़ द क्लिनिकल इम्पोर्टेंस? व्हाई यू आर गोइंग टू डू दिस मैनुअल? क्यों करते हैं ये मैनुअल? To differentiate the venous and arterial pulsation, number one, very important. To differentiate between venous and arterial pulsation. As you press the mid of the abdomen with the palm, it is not necessary to press over the liver or in the right hypochondrium. You can press at the middle of the abdomen with the palm. So it is nowadays is named abdominojugular reflux. as you press the middle of the abdomen with palm, the GVPS transiently rise, while the arterial pulsation does not rise. Number one, to differentiate between venous and arterial pulsation. Number two, very important. What is the other clinical significance of abdominal jugular reflex? To diagnose volume overload. What is the clinical importance? Suppose if there is early stage of heart failure, early stage of right ventricular failure, early stage of pericardial effusion or cardiac tamponade, or early stage of right ventricular infarction, or early stage of congestive heart failure, early stage, still GVP is not raised, still GVP is not elevated. As you press middle of the abdomen with the palm, it is mean you are going to increase the venous return toward right atrium. Do you think this venous return can be accommodated by this diseased heart? It is not accommodated. It is not compensated by this diseased heart. As we know, in normal individual, as we press the middle of the abdomen with the palm, the venous return to right atrium, but the heart is healthy. So heart can compensate, can accommodate this venous return, so that GVP transiently rise, then it will drop. But in case of a diseased heart, the heart cannot compensate, cannot accommodate this venous return. The GVP remain elevated during the period of a compression. जब तक आप कंप्रेस कर रहे हैं तो GVP remain elevated, क्योंकि heart compensate नहीं करता है, accommodate नहीं करेगा. जो ही आपने प्रेशर को रिलीज कर लिया तो जेवीपी विल पार. दैट इज द सेकेंड क्लिनिकल इम्पॉर्टेंस. व्हाट इज द थर्ड क्लिनिकल इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑफ एब्डोमिनो जुगुलर रिफ्लक्स? थर्ड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. टू डिफ्रेंशिएट between obstructive and non-obstructive causes of raised JVP. In obstructive causes such as superior vena cava syndrome, Budd-Carey syndrome, JVP never remain pulsatile. वहाँ pulsation तो नहीं होगा obstructive causes में. There are engorged neck vein without pulsation. What is Kussmaul sign? Kussmaul sign. Stress JVP during? जी डॉक्टर तायर, Kussmaul sign. What is the clinical importance of Kussmaul sign? As we know, normally on inspiration GVP will fall, will drop. During inspiration, intrathoracic pressure decreases. Venous return increases toward right-sided apart. This LT art compensates this venous return. But if there is disease on right-sided of the heart, this venous return cannot be compensated. Normally, inspiration में JVP drop होती है क्योंकि ये venous return is compensated by LT art. If there is a disease such as constrictive pericarditis, rigid pericardium, cardiac tamponade, congestive heart failure, right ventricular failure, do you think this venous return can be compensated by this disease art? Never. Then what happened? Paradoxical elevation of JVP on inspiration is called Cosmol sign. Cosmol sign does not only occur in constrictive pericarditis. It can occur in right ventricular failure, cardiac tamponade, congestive heart failure, right ventricular infarction. Is it clear? What are the causes of visible and raised JVP? What is the difference between visible and raised JVP? JVP is visible, but it is not raised. It is not elevated. As we know, for raised JVP, there is criteria. If it is greater than 3 centimeters, if it is greater than 3 centimeters, we called it is raised or elevated JVP. If it is not raised greater than 3 centimeters, but it is visible, we called it is a visible JVP. It is not raised. What are the causes of raised JVP? Right-sided heart failure. Why not left-sided heart failure? JVP, remember, this is very important point. JVP is the early sign to be appeared and late sign to be disappear in case of congestive heart failure. Very important. It is the early sign to be appeared, JVP, and late sign to be disappeared in case of congestive heart failure. What is the commonest cause of elevated JVP? It's the congestive heart failure. Commonest. We classified it into cardiac and non-cardiac causes. Cardiac and non-cardiac causes. What are the cardiac causes of raised JVP? Congestive heart failure, right ventricular failure, tricuspid stenosis, constrictive pericarditis, pulmonary hypertension, cardiac tamponade, restrictive cardiomyopathy. What are the non-cardiac causes? Non-cardiac causes, Budd-Carey syndrome, Budd-Carey syndrome, other superior Wernicke-Wolf syndrome. Superior Wernicke-Wolf syndrome, Budd-Carey syndrome, these are the non-cardiac causes. What are the other non-cardiac causes? Any hyperdynamic circulation, hyperdynamic state, such as thyrotoxicosis, beriberi, pregnancy is a hyperdynamic circulation, anemia, these are the non-cardiac causes. Non-cardiac causes, up elevated JVP, superior Wernicke-Wolf syndrome, Budd-Carey syndrome, any hyperdynamic state such as thyrotoxicosis, beriberi, pregnancy, anemia. Is it clear? Any question?